Hello guys, welcome in my next tutorial. Today I would like to show you how to crochet this beautiful placemat. So for this project I am using double knit yarn and crochet hook size 4 mm. So as you can see, this project I made by using few different colors of the yarn, and this pattern we can also use for many different projects. For example, we can use for a blanket, or if you would like to make some kind of sweatshirt, this pattern will be perfect as well. So my project is measured about 19.5 inches wide and about 11.5 inches long. So this pattern is quite easy if we would like to make our project smaller or bigger. We are using multiply of 8 chain stitches plus 1. So basically for my project, in first row I've done 65 half double crochets, and we can, as I said, use a different number of stitches, or we can use different type of the yarn and different hook size. So our project, we have to start by making multiply of 8 chain stitches plus 1. So I've done 65 chain stitches, so I've got 8 repeats plus 1 chain stitch at the end. Now we have to work chain of 2, and now into the fourth chain from the hook. So chain of 2 is first half double crochet, 1 and 2, then we have to skip third as well, and into the fourth chain stitch we will work 1 half double crochet as well. And now we have to continue with 1 half double crochet in each chain stitch all the way across, so to the last chain stitch. And at the end we should have 65 half double crochets, or exactly the same number of chain stitches as I said, multiply of 8 plus 1. So we are adding extra half double crochet at the beginning by working chain of 2, but then we have to work into the fourth chain stitch, second double half double crochet and 1 in each stitch. So I should have at the end 65 half double crochets. So I am at the end of my first row, and now we are going to start row number 2. We have to work chain of 2 instead of the first half double crochet, then turn our work. Now we have to skip first stitch because we've done half double crochet already, into the second 1 half double crochet, and again 1 half double crochet in each stitch all the way across. So on the second row we should have exactly the same number of stitches as we've done on the previous one. So again I should have 65 half double crochets. So now just continue with this pattern and I will go back to you at the end. So at the end of our row, the last half double crochet, we have to work into the top of chain 2 from the previous row. But now we are going to change the color of the yarn. So my half double crochet I'm going to finish by using the second color of the yarn. So as you can see, I had my 3 loops on the hook and I just finished the stitch by using the new color. So we have to now work chain 1, what about the white one? We will go back to the white color, so I'm not going to cut the yarn at the moment, and we have to make 1 half double crochet into the first stitch. Then we need to skip the next 3, 1, 2 and 3, and into the 4th we will work 1, 2, 3 and 4, we will work 7 double treble crochets, so 1, 2, 3 and 4. So So we have two, three, and four. We have to yarn over three times, so it's double treble, crochet, and we've got one, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. Then again, we need to skip the next three stitches into the fourth one, one single crochet. Or actually, without a single crochet, we will work chain of one. So as you can see, our work is a little bit waving, that shouldn't be. And now again, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. We have to skip seven stitches, and into the eighth, we will work exactly the same. So seven double treble crochets. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. Chain one, and then again, we have to skip one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, into the eighth, seven double treble crochets. So now just continue to the end. At the end we should skip the last three stitches, and into the last one, into the fourth one, we will work half double crochet. So at the end of our round we have to work, as I said, half double crochet into the last stitch, into the last half double crochet. Then we can fasten off and cut the yarn, or instead of finishing the half double crochet, we can use the white color. I said that I am not cutting the white color at the end of the second row, but basically we have to. It's no chance to go back on this side, it will be too far away. So basically I just cut the end of the white color, and I will start with the white one again here. So I'm going to finish the half double crochet with the white one, with the one white color, and again chain one, then we need to turn our work, one half double crochet into the same stitch, so chain one is not counted as any stitch, and now one half double crochet into the next seven double treble crochets. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. Then we have to work one half double crochet, but into the fourth chain stitch from the second row. One, two, three, and four. Like this. So this half double crochet is supposed to cover the chain one space between two shells. And now again, one half double crochet into the next seven double treble crochets. Two, three, four, five, six, and 7. Half double crochet into the 4th stitch, so 1, 2, 3 and 4. So make sure that we are working on the top of the chain 1. So we have to cover the chain 1 space, and again 1 half double crochet into the next 7 double treble crochets, and we have to continue to the end of this row. Now I am at the end of my row. So far our project doesn't look nice because everything is not staying flat, but to be honest, when we will add more rows, our work supposed to look better. If not, we can always use hot iron to make sure that the project will be looks better. But as you can see, when we will start stretching our stitches, it definitely looks better and laying flat. So again, now we've got row number 5. So we have to start by making chain of 1, and then I will not count this stitch as any stitch, and into the first half double crochet we will work again 1 half double crochet, then 1 half double crochet in each stitch all the way across. So again, at the end of this row we should have the same number of half double crochets as we've done with the first two rows. So in my project I should have 65 half double crochets in total, and I will go back to you at the end of this row to show you how we need to start row number 6. At the end of my row I will work the last half double crochet with the next color of the yarn, and we have to start by making chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So it will be first double treble crochet, and now into the same stitch we have to make another 3 double treble crochets as well. So 1, 2, 3. So we are starting with 4 double treble crochets at the beginning, then chain 1, and we have to skip the next 7 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, into the 8th. So this is exactly the stitch just above the half double crochet as we've done in chain 1 space, on the top of chain 1 space. So one more time, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So we have to work 7 double treble crochets again. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So 7 double treble crochets in one stitch, then chain of 1, and again we have to skip 8 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, we have to skip next 7 stitches, and into the 8th one 7 double treble crochets. So the pattern now is quite similar to the previous row with 7 double treble crochets, only the one difference is because at the end we have to skip the last 8 stitches, and into the 9th, the last one, we have to work 4 double treble crochets again. So exactly the same as we done at the beginning. So just continue to the end and I will go back to you to show you what we have to how we need to start the next row. At the end of our row, on the 4th double treble crochets at the end, we have to finish the stitch with the white color, so exactly the same as each row. We are starting with the next color apart from the second with the white one. And basically what now? Now we have to work chain of one, then we need to turn our work and now into the next four stitches. So including the first half double treble crochets, we have to work half double crochet. So we've got two, three, and then four. Four half double crochets, and now we have to work into the fourth. One, two, three, and four. Half double crochet as well. So again, we have to work on the chain one space between four double treble crochets and another group of seven half double crochets. So as you can see now, this stitch is actually stretching our work, so it makes the nice and flat look. So at the moment this part is a little bit waving as well, but the next row it will be making our work more flat. So now we have to continue with the same pattern, one half double crochet into the next seven double treble crochets. So exactly the same as we've done two rows after the yellow part. And again, instead of working half double crochet into the chain one space, we will work into the fourth chain stitch, into the fourth half double crochet. One, two, three, and four. So make sure that we've got chain one space in the middle. So by working this way, now we have to continue this row to the end, and then again one more row with one half double crochet in each stitch, the same as we've done here. And then next rows we have to continue from in exactly the same way as we start row number three, and continue for as long as we need to. So basically we have to finish this row, then continue in exactly the same row as row two, then continue as row three, four, five, six, and again from row one to row six. I am now at the end of my last row. So basically I've done seven repeats with the colors. I've got seven rows with different colors, as you can see. And I finish with the last two rows with half double crochets. I've done the last row with color and half double crochet, so not the row where we've got four double treble crochets, but only with half double crochet. And now we've got one more thing to do. We have to work on the border because the sides doesn't look really good. And again, for border I will try to make two rounds. If my work that not will be looks good enough, I will decide to make one more, but I'm not quite sure how it will be at the end. Let's see. So basically we have to start by making chain one, and we've got as I said rows with half double crochets. So we will start with half double crochets as well into the same row as we start with half double crochets. On the top of each half double crochet I will try to make two half double crochets. So I've done two half double crochets in first row, then two half double crochets into the second. Now we've got third row, so again one and two. So this is the row where we've done half double crochet at the end, and again we should have two rows with half double crochet. So one half double crochet and second, and into the next one one half double crochet and second. So now we've got row with double treble crochets, and here we have to work five half double crochets. One, two, 3, 4, and 5. Then into the row with half double crochets again, 2 half double crochet in each one. So I didn't finish this one. 1 and 2. Then into the next row again. 1 and 2. And basically this pattern we have to continue to the end, to the corner. At the corner I will show you later on what we have to do. So in each row with half double crochet we have to work 2 half double crochets, and in each row with double treble crochets we have to work 5 half double crochets on the top of the last half double treble crochet. So I've done my first shorter side with half double crochets, and I've done the corner already. So basically here is the last one row, and into the row I've done 4 single crochets. So I thought that 3 will be enough, but I add one extra to make sure that we will have nice corner. And now on the longer side the situation is a little bit easier, because we've got all stitches able to see, and we have to work 1 half double crochet in each stitch. So 1 half double crochet exactly in the same stitch as we've done previous half double crochet from the beginning of our work. So we have to continue with exactly the same way. So again, at the end into the last stitch, into the last half double crochet, so maybe even in the loop, we have to work 4 half double crochets, and we are starting in exactly the same way as we've done with the first short side. So 2 half double crochets in each row with half double crochets, and 5 half double crochets in each row with double treble crochets. So on our second longer side I've done again 1 half double crochet in each half double crochet. At the end into the last half double crochet, instead of only 1, I've done extra 2 half double crochets, so basically 3, and we've got the fourth one as we've done from the beginning. So basically we've done even 2 into the first one, so we have to work slip stitch into the first half double crochet, so not into the chain one, into the half double crochet, and we have to start second the last one round. So as you can see our work looks actually good, so one more round will be absolutely fine. So 1 half double crochet in each half double crochet. At the corner into the center 2, we can work 2 half double crochets in one stitch. So as I said, we've got 4 half double crochets on each corner, so into the first one we will work 1, into the second and third 2 half double crochets, and again into the fourth one only 1, then 1 half double crochet in each stitch all the way across to the next corner, and basically that's it. So as I said, the work is not completely flat, so we have to stretch our stitches, or we can use a little bit hot iron, but if you are using the acrylic yarn, the better is just put something on the top instead of just a hot iron, because our work will be very, very stretchy. So that's it for today. Thank you for staying with me to the end of this tutorial, and see you next time. So if you are like this tutorial, just put your thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel.